The topic is estimating directional derivative. So let's do the first example. Let f of the point p equal 20 and f of q equal 8, where p is equal to 5 and q is equal to 2.2, 4.9. And the question is, approximate the directional derivative of f at p in the direction of q. All right, so estimation is right here, the definition. It's going to be f of q, so f in the direction of pq. Of course, it's not unit vector, but we're just approximating. Is equal f of q minus f of p, that's a formula, over the norm of pq, or the distance between p and q. It means the same thing. Distance between p and q means the norm of the vector pq. So this is equal f of q means f of the point 2.2, 4.9 minus f of the point p is 2.5 over the distance of the vector pq. Remember, pq, let me do it here, pq is equal x2, so let's call this x1, y1, and this is x2, y2. So x2 minus x1 means 2.2 minus 2i plus y2, 4.9 minus 5j, which is equal to 0.2i, let's do vector, 0.2i, and then 0.1, negative 0.1j. So this is my pq. So I need the norm of that. So what's the norm of the vector? The norm of the vector is square root of 0.2 squared plus negative of 0.1 squared. Now this is going to be equal f of 2.2, 4.9. How do I find that? It's given right here. So f of q is 8. So this is given 8 minus f of 2.5. F of 2.5 is given to be 20. Divided by square root of 0.2 square plus negative 0.1 square square root. If you use your calculator, you're supposed to get 54.54. All right, now for the next problem is a little bit different. You'll be given p equal negative 1, 2 and q equal negative 1.5, 1.8. But we're supposed to approximate the directional derivative of f of xy equal x squared y at p in the direction of pq. So again, same thing for the pq. To find pq is the vector x2. This is x1, y1, x2, y2. So negative 1.5. minus negative 1, and then 1.8 minus 2, 1.8 minus 2, which is the vector pq. The vector pq is equal to negative 1.5 plus 1 is negative 0.5, 1.8 minus 2 is negative 0.2. All right, now we need the norm. Norm of PQ will be equal negative 0.5 squared plus negative 0.2 squared square root, which is 0.53. What else we're gonna need? So let's write the definition and we see. So again, f in the direction of pq, and I know it's not a normal vector, it's not a unit vector, but we're not going to use estimation. So same way, it's f of q minus f of p divided by the norm of pq. Only difference this time, the denominator we know, we just calculated, which is 0.53. But f of q is not given like the previous problem, but we can still plug it in. So f of q means plug this x into here, so that would be negative 1.5 squared, times the y will be 1.8, and then minus. Now what is f of p? F of p is, plug in the 2, plug in negative 1 into x, so negative 1 squared times the y, which is 2. So from here, it's just using a calculator. If you do that, you're supposed to get 0.47. And that's it for this example.